All in all, it hadn't been a good day. Bad traffic, a malfunctioning computer, incompetent workers, and a sore back all made me seething cauldron of rage. But more importantly for this story, it had been over 48 hours since last I'd taken a dump. I tried to jumpstart the process, beginning my day with a bowl of bowel-cleansing fiber cereal, filling it with 6 cups of coffee at work, and adding a Bin Laden lunch at Taco Bell. As I was returning home from work, my insides let me know that subtle rumbles and an emission from the occasional tiny fart that big things would be happening soon. Alas, I had to stop at the mall to pick up an order for my fiancé. I completed this task, and as I was walking past the stores on my way back to the car, I noticed a large sales sign proclaiming, "Everything must go!" This was prophetic, for my colon informed me with a sudden violent cramp and a wet, squeaky fart that everything was indeed about to go. I hurried to the mall bathrooms. I surveyed the 5 stalls, which I've numbered 0 through 4. I write a lot of software, for your convenience. 0. Occupied. 1. Clean, but bathroom protocol forbids to use it, as it's next to the occupied one. 2. Poo on the seat. 3. Poo and toilet paper in the bowl. Unidentified liquid splattered on seat. 4. No toilet paper. No stall door. Unidentifiable sticky object near base of toilet. Clearly, it had to be stall 1. I trudged back, entered, dropped trowel, and sat down. I'm normally a fairly shameful shitter. I wasn't happy about being next to an occupied stall, but big things were afoot. I was just getting ready to bear down when all of a sudden the sweet sounds of Beethoven came from the next door, followed by a fumbling and the sound of a voice answering the ringing phone. As usual from a cell phone conversation, the voice was exactly 8 decibels louder than it needed to be. Out of shameful habit, my sphincter slammed shut. The inane conversation went on and on. Mr. Shitter was blathering to Mrs. Shitter about how shitty the day he had. I sat there, cramping and miserable, waiting for him to finish. As the loud conversation dragged on, I became angrier and angrier, thinking that I, too, had a crappy day, but I was too polite to yak about it in public. My bowels let me know in no uncertain terms that if I didn't get crapping soon, my day would be getting even crappier. Finally, my anger reached a point that overcame shamefulness. I no longer cared. I gripped the toilet paper holder with one hand, braced my other hand against the side of the stall, and pushed with all my might. I was rewarded with a fart of colossal magnitude, a cross between the sound of someone ripping a very wet bedsheet in half and plywood being torn off a wall. The sound gradually transitioned into a heavy modulated RPM tone, not unlike someone firing up a Harley. I managed to hit the Renaissance frequency of the stall, and it shook gently. Once my ass cheeks stopped flapping in the breeze, 3 things became apparent. 1. The next door conversation had ceased. 2. My colon continued seizing indicated that there was more to come. And 3. The bathroom was now beset by a horrible, eldritch stench. It was as if a gateway to hell had been opened. The foul miasma quickly made its way underneath the stall and began choking up my poop mate. This initial herald fart had ended his conversation in mid-sentence.
"Oh my god!"
I heard him mutter, filling it with the suppressed sounds of choking, and then,
"No, baby. That wasn't me. You could hear that?"
Now there was no stopping me. I pushed for all that I was worth. I could swear that the resulting cacophony of rips, squirts, splashes, poots, and blasts that I was actually lifted slightly off the pot. The amount of stuff in me was incredible. It spread against the bowl with tremendous force. Later, in surveying the damage, I'd see that liquid poop had actually managed to ricochet out of the bowl and run down the side on the floor. But for now, all I could do was hang on for the ride. Next door, I could hear him fumbling with the paper dispenser as he desperately tried to finish his task. Little snatches of conversation made themselves heard over my anal symphony.
"Gotta go. Horrible. Throw up. My mouth. Not make it. Tell the kids I love them. Oh god."
Followed by more sounds of suppressed gagging and retching. Alas, is it as indefinitely difficult to hold one's phone and wipe one's bum at the same time? Just as my high-pressure abuse at the toilet was winding down, I heard a plop and a splash from the next door, followed by a string of swear words and gags. My poop mate had dropped his phone into the toilet. There was a lull in my production, and the restroom had become deathly quiet. I could envision him standing there, wondering what to do. A final anal announcement came trumpeting from my behind, small trunks propping noisily into the water. That must have been the last straw. I heard a flush, a fumbling with the lock, and then the stall door was thrown open. I heard him running out of the bathroom, slamming the door behind him. After a considerable amount of paperwork, I got up and surveyed the damage. I felt bad for the janitor who'd be forced to deal with this, but I knew flushing was not an option. No toilet in the world could handle my unholy mess. Flushing would only lead to a floor flooded with filth. As I left, I glanced into the next door stall. Nothing remained in the bowl. He had flushed his phone, or had plucked it out and left the bathroom with that nasty unwashed hands. The world will never know. I exited the bathroom, momentarily proud and shameless, looking around for a face glaring at me, but I saw no one. I suspect that somehow my supernatural elimination had managed to flush my transfer of shamefulness to my anonymous poop mate. I think I'll be a long time before he can bring himself to poop in public, and I doubt he'll ever again answer his cell phone in the loo. And this, my friends, is why you should never talk on your phone in the bathroom.